Hello guys, today's video will be about how to install and how to use the Substance Link add-on in Blender. So let's get started. Before installing the plugin, you need to make sure you have Python and the Substance Automation Toolkit installed on your computer. Both the plugin and the Automation Toolkit work with Python 2.7 and 3.6 versions. If you have a Mac, Python is already installed, so you can skip this step. If you have a PC, you need to download it from python.org/downloads. Once you download it, just run the executable. While installing, be sure that Add Python to Path is checked. Next, you need to add the Automation Toolkit. You can find it in your licenses page in the Algorithmics website. Download it and follow the installer. As I already have the Automation Toolkit, I will cancel the installation. Now we need to add the Automation Toolkit to the Python path. The easiest way is with the pip command. So we open the command prompt and type pip --- version. If the command is recognized, you can skip this step. If not, just write isinstall pip. In Mac, you'll probably need to type sudo isinstall pip and type your password, otherwise you'll find a write permission error. With pip installed, we need to add the Automation Toolkit to the Python path, and to do it, we need to type pip install and the path of the Automation Toolkit folder. In Windows, it is usually located in Program Files, Algorithmic, Substance Automation Toolkit, Python API, and there's a zip file called PySBS with the version. Don't forget that the path includes the PySBS zip file, where the X, Y, and Z are the toolkit version. With Python and the Automation Toolkit installed and working, the next step is to install the add-on. Once you downloaded the zip file from Gumroad, you'll find three files: a DMG to install the plugin in Mac, an exe to install the plugin in Windows, and a zip file to install the add-on in Blender. Let's start with Blender. So open it, go to File, User Preferences, Add-ons, and click Install Add-on from File. Select the zip file and activate the add-on. You will now see a panel in the left called Xolotl that will have the Substance Link plugin. Now, just double-click and install the plugin with the DMG or exe depending on your operating system, and we are ready to use it. To use the plugin in Blender, all you need to do is click Start Listening in the Xolotl tab. Now, Substance Link will be able to communicate with Blender. This release works with Cycles and Eevee. If you have another renderer selected, it will change by default to Cycles when you click the Start Listening button. The interval parameter defines how often the plugin will check for new information coming from the Substance Link. If the scene becomes kind of laggy, you might want to increase the parameter value. Also, we have three buttons. Delete unused materials will remove all the materials that are not assigned in the scene. Delete unused textures will remove all the textures that are not assigned. And delete unused that will remove both materials and textures. Now let's check the Substance Link application. I made it as an external application mainly because the Automation Toolkit has some issues if you use it directly inside Blender, and also as a workaround to all the possible licensing issues that have prevented previous Blender and Substance integrations. Here we have two tabs: Substance Database and Output Parameters. When we expand the Substance Database tab, we can set up the basic configurations: the Blender plugin path and the database folder path. The Blender plugin path is where we just install the plugin. In Windows, the path is usually users, your username, app data, roaming, Blender Foundation, the Blender version, scripts, add-ons, and XLSBSR link. Don't forget to include the XLSBSR link at the end. Then we have the database folder path, which is the place where we have all our Substance files. After setting up both paths, we can click Save Paths and the configuration will remain after closing the app. The Reload Database button will reload the database according to the path established in the database folder path parameter. Now, in the Output Parameter tab, we'll configure the way the output textures of the substance will be created, including the output path, the width, height, file extension, etc. If you forget to set up an output path, the app won't create any materials. To add the substance to Blender, once we make sure the plugin is listening, we need to select a substance file. When we do so, a Create Material button will appear as well as its corresponding parameters. As you can see, these parameters will change dynamically according to the selected substance. We just need to adjust the parameter we want and click Create Material. This will create the material in the scene with all the necessary connections. Now, you just assign the material and make sure that the right UVs are selected in the UV node. If you need to go back and edit the material or its parameters, you just have to click Create Material again, and the changes will be visible automatically in Blender. This way you can add and modify as many substances you want in your scene. It is important to keep in mind that this add-on only works with substances that have the necessary outputs for the PBR metal roughness workflow, which is usually the standard in all the substances from Substance Source. Well, that's all for now. If you have any doubts or requests, let me know in the comments or via our Discord server.
Good luck!